But next, we have WXAC, Albright College Radio's own Mindy Cohen. She's going to be talking about, Mindy. She started her career at the age of 5 playing piano, and in her 20s found her passion for radio. And she's going to be talking about, grapevine. People say things, you know? She's going to be talking about her experience in radio and how she got to the position that she is. So please help me welcome Mindy Cohen.
Actually, radio is a second, third, maybe fourth career change for me. I was glad that somebody did ask about the importance of radio, because when I was originally going to, I've written 4 or 5 different things to talk about today and threw them all away. The first one was talking about the death of radio, because how many people here listen to the radio in the car? Really? How many listen to the radio in the house? A few of you do. Okay, that's wonderful. Most audiences will say, nah, not really. But they don't realize, actually, that if they're listening to streaming, they're also listening to the radio. So there will always be radio out there. It's not going to be the radio that we see pictures of families sitting around in like 1945 listening to news about World War II. You know, and the whole family's looking at the radio like it's supposed to do something, you know. And it's also not going to be radio like it was in the 60s or 70s, which actually, you know, caused a revolution in this country. It's radio that is going to sell you music. And how it's going to do that is changing also, and I'm not sure how that's going. In the past, we had DJs, and I had favorite DJs when I was growing up. There was somebody in New York called Allison Steele. She was the night owl. She came on at 10 o'clock, and you knew if you wanted like really moody stuff, that was where you would hear it. And there was somebody else in the morning who always played Bruce Juice. And you'd hear, you know, tracks by Bruce Springsteen there that you never heard anyplace else before. And you had a relationship with the DJ. Now there's very few relationships with DJs because you've got some guy sitting in a room in Podunk, you know, with logarithms, who is determining what you're going to hear. And that's what places like iHeartRadio actually do. They're really good at using computer programs to decide what you are going to hear. And you want to think that it's actually a more creative choice, and you hope that you're making your choice creatively, but you have to grab the bull by the horns now to do that. It is not easy to find. It's not easy to find new music that's really good because there's no one telling you about it and playing it. If you're streaming on one of the services, you might hear new music, but that doesn't mean it's good. It just means that somebody's pushing it at you. So how do you find good music? I still think we need radio. We need people going into radio, doing shows, listening to music, screening that music, saying, wow, I know this is going to be a hit. I was doing radio, and I'm going to go back and forth between personal experience and opinion. I was doing radio in Europe in the 1990s, and I remember when I was visiting the States, and Nirvana's album hadn't broken in Europe yet. And I was in LA, and I bought the CD, and I listened to it, and I said, oh my God, this is great. And obviously, I don't have to tell you anymore about Nirvana, but I was able to break that CD in Switzerland, which is no big deal, but it was a big deal, because people listened to my show to hear what I was going to play. And I think that when we have students doing shows, alternative radio shows, on places like WXAC and college radio stations around the country, they're the only ones who are bringing you music that they honestly care about and music that they really like, and they're not beholden to promoters, they're not beholden to anybody who's telling them that they've got to play something, except maybe their musical director who says, please play 3 formats an hour, because we get free music that way. But otherwise, it's college radio right now in this country is the only place to hear alternative music and not something that, you know, and I've got nothing against the big acts, say, like Taylor Swift, but it doesn't belong on a college alternative radio station. And you don't hear really creative new people who don't have big agents behind them, like the musicians, many of them who are here today, get to have. We play those people on college radio. And so it's really important to keep radio alive and college radio alive. A lot of stations recently have been bought up by church stations. Colleges are having financial difficulty. Traditionally, college radio stations are not on the air 24/7. They have a lot of dead air. And so colleges make their point with the FCC, and they say to them, listen, we'll buy that station, and we will keep people on the air 24/7, which will better serve the community. And they're winning college radio stations that way. And so it will be very, very sad when non-profit radio disappears from the airwaves, and that's happening. And so the way to do it is, we're really lucky here at WXAC because our students are really engaged, and they are doing shows every day from about 2 in the afternoon till midnight. But we got really lucky also because we had to look outside the box. We could not fill up the airwaves before 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Students were in classes, students just were sleeping, you know, they want to get up and do a radio show at 9 o'clock in the morning, frankly. But we have a large Latino population here in Reading. So we went and we found some DJs in Reading who wanted to volunteer and do Spanish language radio. There was none here in Reading before we put it on the air. And so for about 10 years now, we've had Spanish radio on the air from 7 a.m. till 2 p.m., which keeps anybody from trying to challenge our license. But it also serves a real great service to the community, which buys the college some good PR in the community. You know, so it's really important to look at those relationships and build them, and that will keep radio strong, and independent radio and independent musicians and the whole non-corporate world. Because right now, iHeartRadio is buying every station pretty much in every market. And then that means you will get to hear a country station, a top 10 pop station, or a top 40 pop station, and maybe, you know, an oldies station playing 80s till today, or, you know, 70s music. And that is all you will hear. You won't hear the guy who's not getting picked up by, you know, Atlantic Records or Sony. But those are the people you hear on college radio. So I know it's lunchtime, and I feel really bad being the person on before lunch. Does anybody have any questions or comments about radio yet?
I asked the question about how radio affected that, too. And one of the questions I was thinking about, and I'm glad you pointed it out, about the large Hispanic population that's here. And I wonder how that radio show that you're talking about on the radio station brings in Hispanic artists to the area, to maybe to the stadium and other venues.
We are really influential in the Spanish community, and any big show that comes to the area, obviously college radio does not do advertising, but we do underwriting. So we let people know, and interestingly, all of our underwriting is on the Spanish program. So fortunately for us, we get to have that kind of money brought into our station because student programming doesn't bring it in. And all of our community DJs are also volunteers. So we got really, really lucky. We bring in shows, people want to sell stuff to the community, and we're the only game in town. So it's worked really, really well for us and for the community. And because, to be honest, the Reading community is not the wealthiest or best educated community. They've come here for jobs, which have dried up in factories and in agriculture. And so it's not a well-empowered community, and we have been able to do something about that. And we have we've teamed with government and non-governmental agencies. It's cost us nothing, but we have all these people come in and do shows on, for example, the women's shelter in the area is doing a show with us, and they found that their inquiries, they're here half hour once a month. Inquiries in Spanish language went up 65% after they were on the air for 3 months. That's really important. That's having an impact. When Obama was running for president the first time, I'm not talking about politics here. I'm not saying who I supported. I didn't support anybody. The radio station is totally impartial. But I was sitting in a cafe with my laptop, and I looked at a voter irregularity site, and they were saying that people in Reading were getting phone calls, Latinos were getting phone calls, being told that Democrats would be voting on Wednesday and Republicans would be voting on Tuesday because they're expecting a very high turnout. And I'm sitting there and I'm looking at this, and I was really, just my jaw dropped. And I thought, what can I do about this? This is really awful. And I said, idiot, you have the largest mouthpiece here in Reading in reaching the Spanish market. And I called somebody from the Berks County Board of Elections, and she was on the air a half an hour later talking about voter rights and regularities. And we recorded that and we played it every half hour between that Friday and Tuesday, Election Day. And it was the first time, and I don't know if we have anything to do with this, but it was the first time that Berks County voted for a Democratic candidate for president in 51 years. Maybe it was the Latino vote in the city, maybe it was something else, I don't know. But I do know we really did get out the vote. So it's another time where there was some impact from what we do. We work with Berks County's Office of the Aging. They do a show on Grandma's Not Crazy. She's got a disease, it's called Alzheimer's, here's where to get help. Or how to help Grandma in and out of a car. Or to go supermarket shopping for Grandma and Grandpa because they can't do it anymore. We have, you know, we're able to address a lot of issues. We've partnered with the Reading Public Library. I just started a book club, a bilingual book club on the air, and we're reading Sonia Sotomayor's autobiography. She is the first Latina on the Supreme Court. So this partnering with the Latino community has really saved our alternative radio station. And I think a lot of colleges have looked at us as a leader in this and have followed suit looking for ways to save their college radio station. So I'm really proud of the work that we do and the people that work at the station, the students who work there, some of whom are also involved in Lion Enterprises. And they work their butts off. Our music director, for example, you know, he's in the office 7 or 8 hours a week listening to 40, 50 new CDs that come in, deciding which ones are going for, you know, ads and writing notes on the CD so other DJs will know that track number 5 is not clean, don't play it. Or this is a great song, I don't know if you would normally listen to it, but listen to track 11 here. And, you know, that's how we keep getting free music also. So anybody have any questions?
I don't have a question, just a request, especially since we have so many guests here today. Can you just explain the award that everybody at WXAC just won?
Yeah, we just won an award from our peers. It was the Silver Microphone for Excellence in Broadcasting because of the work we do. And yeah, pretty good. And it's because our students and our community volunteers are really amazing. I just, you know, sort of sit in my office and oversee everything and say, wow, you're great, and, you know, play mommy, and it's perfect. So, all right, go eat. Thank you.